Lately, I've been working on a project that requires high performance, so I decided to try using raw sockets to send and receive JSON messages over TCP and UDP. I wanted to compare latency and throughput I could achieve with each protocol without relying on any frameworks. I used C++ language and followed what I think is the best networking guide on the internet right now. When you measure performance of anything, you need to pay attention to latency and throughput. Latency in this example refers to how much time it takes to send and receive a JSON message from one computer to another. We usually use percentiles such as P50, P90, and P99 to measure it. For instance, P90 percentile indicates how long it takes for 90% of all messages to be sent and received by the second server. Similarly, P99 represents 99% of all messages or requests, and so on. The other important metric is throughput, which measures how many of these messages can be sent and received simultaneously. We typically measure it in messages per second, requests per second, or queries per second, depending on what's been evaluated. Very frequently, if something is optimized for low latency, it may have lower throughput, and vice versa. In this test, you'll see exactly that. Well, you're probably aware that TCP is a much more reliable protocol, and it requires establishing a TCP connection first. On the server side, we'll create a socket, which returns a file descriptor. Then we'll use it to bind to a port on the server, such as port 8080. After that, we'll start listening for incoming connections. The next function, accept, will block and wait for the incoming requests. On the client side, we also need to create a socket. Then we'll run connect function to connect to the server. At this point, accept function on the server will return the client's file descriptor, which we can use to read and write data. For example, we can send hello message and the client would use receive function to read all our messages. Now, if for some reason client doesn't receive the entire message, for example, if one character is missing, it would ask the server to resend it. This is why TCP considered reliable. Both the client and server verify that all data is properly received in the same order with nothing missing. On the UDP side, the server also needs to create a socket and bind it to the port. However, it doesn't need to establish a connection with the client. It can simply start receiving messages using receive from function. The client, on the other hand, doesn't need to call connect function or create a connection. It can just start sending messages to the server and hope the server is already listening and accepting them. In this case, the client is unaware of the server's status and keeps sending messages regardless. This actually allows UDP to have lower latency. Since there is no connection, the server cannot acknowledge that all data has been received, and UDP messages can sometimes arrive with missing data or out of order. That's totally fine. We use it in video and audio streaming, as well as trading systems, where latency is critical. Finally, when you use TCP, it is always a direct connection between a client and a server. For example, if you have multiple clients and a single server, each client must establish a new TCP connection to start sending and receiving data. So in TCP, it's one-to-one relationship. Now, with UDP, you can actually send messages to all computers on your local network at the same time. For example, in AWS VPC. This is called broadcasting. Every single server will receive your message and process it. However, this isn't always efficient if only a few computers need to receive it. Instead, you can use multicasting to send those messages to only selected servers on your network. In this case, you would have a single producer and possibly multiple consumers. I used C++ language to create TCP and UDP servers and clients, and you can find the source code in my public GitHub repository. I also instrumented each client with Prometheus metrics. I used histogram to measure latency, and I had to create additional counter metric to measure throughput due to some exceptions. In the following video, I'll provide a short guide on how to get started with sockets from scratch using C++ or C language. I run this benchmark on AWS using dedicated VM for TCP and UDP servers and clients. Since I built a single-threaded application that can only use one CPU core at a time, I used M7A medium EC2 instance type with one CPU and 4 GB of memory. Of course, I used EKS to run Prometheus and other monitoring components. Alright, let's go ahead and run the test. It took maybe an hour to complete, and I compressed it to just a couple of minutes. Compared to other tests I've run in the past, this one has only 2 stages. In the first stage, I start sending around 16,000 messages per second and measure latency as well as CPU usage of each VM involved in the test. For example, you can see that TCP server has the highest usage due to validations built into the TCP protocol. Right from the start, you can see that the latency for sending messages over UDP is significantly lower than TCP, which is probably exactly what would you expect. I used the same setup for this test and the same JSON message size, around 110 bytes. So you can compare this latency with any other HTTP frameworks I've tested on this channel. Typically, latency would be between 300 and 600 microseconds per request. Sometimes this is caused by the higher level HTTP protocol built on top of TCP, and sometimes it's because those HTTP requests are not persistent, requiring us to occasionally create a new TCP connection. Some protocols, like WebSockets, use keep alive and reuse the same TCP connection, so it's very protocol specific. Alright, the next stage is to send as many messages as each server can handle without any artificial delay. By doing this, we can compare the throughput of each protocol. For some of you, it won't be surprising that TCP actually has much higher throughput due to the congestion control built into it. You can run 1000 TCP connections at the maximum speed, and all 1000 connections will be productive because they sense available bandwidth. With UDP, when you push packets as fast as you can, you may actually reduce throughput. You can also see very high latency on the TCP side. This is mostly because the TCP server can deliver more messages than the client can read. To measure latency, I insert a timestamp in each message and parse it on the client side. So the high TCP latency might be slightly misleading, but TCP definitely requires more CPU power to process all these messages. So UDP is not always the fastest protocol. It works great on a small scale, but if you actually care about throughput or how many messages or requests you can process per second, you would be better off with standard TCP protocol. I should mention that there are many different protocols built on top of UDP that implement some form of packet level verification to add reliability. But again, you need to test it yourself and always measure everything. Thank you for watching, and I have other benchmarks that you might find interesting, comparing different databases, caches, and so on.